We're here at the Chicago Auto Show, and I'm standing next to a huge deal car for Kia's future. It's the all-new, all-electric EV6. We're going to tell you everything we know about and take our official first look. Now, if you're thinking to yourself, hey, I've seen this car before, you're not wrong. Kia did pull the cover off just a few months ago, but this is our first opportunity to get up close with the car and see it in the US for the first time. Those that are well-versed in Hyundai Kia know that this shares a lot in common with the Hyundai Ioniq 5. They have a platform, same wheelbase, but the difference is how they're designed. In true Hyundai Kia fashion, that car takes a very retro, sort of old school approach with how it looks. This is all about hard angles and futuristic presence. Before we get into the nerdy details with batteries and powertrains and horsepower figures, all the things we love with electric vehicles, let's just take a second to appreciate this car's design for what it is. At the front here, we have the brand new Kia corporate logo. It sits proud on the hood. There's this gorgeous matte finish paint. Of course, that's going to be an option. But the details up front, look at the headlights specifically. They themselves are subtle, but we have this really striking lighting signature that goes around it. Absolutely gorgeous. Then underneath, we have these kind of hard triangular elements that bring in the center of the face. Come around to the side of the car with me, where the name of the game here is short overhangs at the front and the rear. And what that does is it gives the car a more sort of hunkered down, aggressive presence. These right here are sort of an arrow pattern 20-inch wheel. You can actually get all the way up to 21-inch wheels, and we'll talk about that more in a sec. As we go back like here, you can see the roofline somewhat sloping down. You get a little bit of Kia Soul in the design. I actually get a little bit of Jaguar I-Pace as well. But overall, some really nice shapes and very subtle cues with the body paneling. There's one big body line that runs here, but otherwise it's just nice, clean, smooth surfaces. And come closer right here because there's this neat little Easter egg. Underneath is an LED light, so when you unlock the car and approach it, especially at night, there's an LED light that shines right here because the Kia designers wanted to specifically highlight just how smooth this body panel was. In terms of powertrains and batteries and all that, there's a few different options with the EV6. It's gonna get a little confusing, so hang on. There are three different trim levels of the base car. The entry-level one is going to be a rear-wheel drive model with 167 horsepower. Then there's an upgraded version of that with 218 horsepower. And finally, a dual motor all-wheel drive version with 313 horsepower. Best case scenario for that car is going to be about 300 miles of range. Then the thing we're really excited about, which is the EV6 GT. You've already heard me mention that. That is the performance version. It's gonna have 577 horsepower. It's gonna hit 60 miles an hour in 3.5 seconds. If you've been in any modern Kia product, there's a lot here that is familiar, but boy, at the same time, is there a lot that's different and specific to EV6. Up here, we have two 12-inch displays, but they're in this really nice singular housing. The one on the right is a touchscreen, and that's gonna function as your infotainment setup, CarPlay, Android Auto, all that good stuff. But over here, we have a nice new digital instrument cluster with sort of a unique design for EV6. I've never seen this in a Kia before. Same thing with the steering wheel. This two-spoke design looks a lot more futuristic and looks befitting of a future EV. In the center console right here, there's this really neat strip of ambient lighting. It sort of curves around the cup holders. Then we have more ambient lighting that runs across the dash. Also kind of unique are the heated and cooled seat controls. They're touch capacitive right here, as are the controls for the HVAC system. One other thing to point out is because this is an electric vehicle, there's no transmission tunnel, massive amounts of storage underneath, and then three USB-C ports to go as well. Kia intends to start delivering these things to customers at the end of 2021, but we're gonna have to wait until the end of 2022 for the EV6 GT. For more on the EV6 and all the cars we're covering here at the Chicago Auto Show, be sure to follow us at Motor1.com on social media and subscribe to our YouTube channel.